お前は増援の指揮につけ。わしは。
Get your extra bitch ass out of here, motherfucker.
This is clearly all chill. Like, girl,
yeah.
Fine.
Guys, it's fine.
Stop freaking the fuck out.
That's pants on my property. You didn't win shit in my yard.
Wait.
All of you.
Daddy, chill.
What the hell is even that?
Hey, what's going on, guys? Just want to thank you guys very much for stopping by the channel. Just remember, if you want to help us out, just give us a little bit of a like and subscribe. It helps us out tremendously. And if you want to get early access to next week's episode, you can hit us up on our Patreon. All right, now I will stop yakking, and let's get on with the Attack on Titan reactions. What's up, everybody? It's me, Sean Tank Top. I'm over here at Casa de Tank Top. I'm hanging out with my very good friends, Dustin and Morgan, over at Dojo Dre's. How you doing over there, y'all?
Man, I cannot wait to find out what the fuck is going on.
I know, I gotta.
What the fuck is fucking going on?
I'm a human! No, you're not.
Right, I'm a human. But like now, okay, we're watching Attack on Titan. And, you know, we've been chomping at the bit to get back into this thing. Because we had, I mean, like, I don't know. They've had like cliffhanger-ish type of things. Like, you know, and the show's done them pretty well to just be like, oh my God, what the fuck is going on? And this was the kind of, at least so far in the show, I'm sure there'll be something that also eclipses it later on throughout the seasons. But like, this is on the top of Mount What the Fuck.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So far, and all of a sudden we're sitting inside of like a partially muscled Titan skeleton.
Yeah.
Of which him and Mikasa and fucking and Armin are just like inside of and stuff like that. You know what I mean? Like, and I think that they're going to, I think that we're going to hit the road and we're going to go check out and see what the fuck's going on in that basement.
Yeah, let's get in that basement.
Yeah, dude.
Are you sure about that?
It was the most kind of breathless that I'd been. Shit's wild. And it's been getting wilder and wilder, too.
I'm excited.
I mean, do you think that we're going to get out there, or do you think that we're going to get into the basement at all in this episode?
They're going to get outside the walls and try and go, because like the outskirts of the city where his house was has been lost. And they're trying
it's
to
full of Titans.
Yeah, they're trying to retake that wall. That was like kind of the thing. I'm going to predict that somehow they're going to get in leagues with the recon people, and the recon people are going to become like their friends. So they're going to be like the recon people and this trio.
They're the ones that saw him like taking motherfuckers out. Like that was kind of the frustrating thing about that whole thing, where you're just like, listen, people saw that. Like he was a Titan, but he was fucking,
he was on your side
and bodying like all these other fucking all these other ones. So like that was kind of the thing that was frustrating about it. So I think you might be onto something with that. Maybe we won't get to the basement. Maybe we just gotta make
who's
some
that?
Plans.
Who's first. The all-star, the captain? That's like that real
Son of a bitch. What's his name? It's not Pixies.
Elton or whatever. It's not like that guy. The guy who's like a germaphobe.
Irwin. E-R-W-I-N, Irwin maybe, I think. I think that's who it is.
Irwin, Armin, Aaron. Like, they're all very similar.
Yeah, there's a lot of,
And they all kind of look similar-ish.
Right. Yeah, totally. A little bit. And like, so, but I think that might be something too. Like, and that would be cool. Like, to watch them fighting alongside, like, gnarly fucking, I don't know, what would you call it? He's like a 90s era grunge titan that Aaron kind of becomes a little bit. You know what I mean?
Well,
like,
he
just needs some flannel and a couple of Pearl Jam records.
He looks
there.
He could join the gorillas.
Yeah. Man, how excited would that murder scientist be when she's all excited about trying to find the abnormal ones? If she found out about, like,
she'd be like, do you want to be my boyfriend? He's like, sorry, I'm taken.
Sorry, you know, I got my girl Mikasa over here, and she's kind of also a little bit better of a murder child than you are. We're trauma bonded.
I know. I mean, like, they got a lot of threads going with this thing. I'm just impatient, and I just want to
get
going.
Let's do it.
I can't really speculate. I mean, you guys ready to go?
Yes. Yeah.
Fuck yeah, man. All right, well, cool. We appreciate you guys hanging out with us while we check out Attack on Titan, while we've been going on through our Attack on Titan journey. If you want to help support the channel and to give us a little bit of support and to unlock some really cool exclusive content, including we're watching episode 10 right now on YT, but available on our Patreon at this very moment is episode 11.
What is he doing?
Whoa.
What the fuck?
Every time we drop something on YT, that week we drop the next week's episode. So you get to watch that right now, and you get to watch it full, and you get to watch it uncut. So check on over to our Patreon to find that. The link's below. And if you can do that, hit us with a like and a subscribe if you're enjoying yourself on this video. It helps us a lot, and we appreciate y'all very much. Let's find out what's going on with this here fucking weird a new anatomy man.
Yeah.
A new guy.
Yeah. It's
so gross, hanging out in his bowels.
Ugh.
Now I just want to know who these guys are.
Yeah, who are they?
Who's in their necks?
Why are they doing this?
Who's rocking that juicy dumper right there? I want to hear like a fucking like a trap remix of this.
I tried
like,
to find one. Good luck.
Oh,
good
really? Luck. Oh man.
If anyone has one that they like.
Send it to us.
Send it our way, absolutely. I think he's very sassily bringing yeah. his fucking hand.
Like, that's really, that was that meme. Is he, you know?
Oh, this guy's having a day. Potato girl.
She's full of carbs. Oh, okay. See? She wants potatoes. She's hungry.
She's like, I don't give a shit about this breakdown right now.
They found out.
Yeah, they might have found out a little bit.
Ooh, they're like on the other side of the wall.
Oh, fuck. Here we go.
Oh, wow.
I love when the soundtrack gets all like weird.
Yeah, for sure.
Broken fax machine.
Jump! It's Marvin! Your cousin Marvin Perry! You know that new sound you're looking for?
Look at this. I love that Mikasa is not fucking worried about it at all.
Ew.
Ooh, it's in his fucking face and shit. Oh, wow. Man.
Yeah, dude. Figure it out. Okay, Whoa. It's just a dead, empty thing now. Wait, they have like the ground and flowers in there?
Yeah. That thing's gonna crumble.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, get the fuck out of there.
Frozen.
Run, dude.
There you go. Got it.
Nice. Basement.
Let's get there.
Less regretty, more runny.
Yeah,
right. It's like we need to have this, but on the run. I think is like what. But I think that's also the very much the kind of the anime of it all, where they're just like we just got to have this moment where we just really kind of express the everything that he's going through.
Yeah, Mikasa. That's our girl.
I mean, he just did it.
Oh, is it kind of like, is it sort of like 11, like when he uses the power, it takes a little something out of him? It's got to be a little something
like
that, right? You need to get to the mess hall with Sasha and get some bite to eat, buddy.
No, you're not.
He's pulling like he's like I can be the bad guy, like he's pulling like a Dark Knight. He's like I'm the Titan that we need, but not the one that we deserve right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeast.
Ooh.
Tell us about yeast.
This guy's fucked.
He's tweaking.
Yeah, he's brain broke. Yeah.
Mikasa's senses are sharper than a stray cat's.
He's gonna have a plan.
Yeah.
Oh, you gotta give yourself a little more credit than that,
buddy.
Come on, dog. Come on.
I just keep seeing those babies again. Oh, get over it.
Jeez. How many times is he going to do this speech? He does the speech at least like once an episode.
Like once every other episode. He's just got to talk about I'd rather die than be a burden or something like that.
Yeah, yeah. It's like, kid, you already did some shit.
You came up with a kick-ass plan that killed so many fucking of these things. You know what I mean? Like he puts himself on square one every time, whereas like he doesn't have it. He doesn't remember like the things that he's done. You know.
Armin, ato o mae no hantan ni makaseru.
Yeah,
you're the tiebreaker.
Armin ga moshi koko de ore wa kyoui janai te koto o chūton heidan ni settoku dekiru to iu nara, ore wa o mae o shinjite sore ni shitagau. 15 myo inai ni kimete kure.
Oh my god.
You're sitting there just having like a pity party by yourself. Like we got decisions that need to be made.
Didn't he just say 15 seconds?
Yeah.
It's been 15 seconds.
It has been 15 seconds. Yeah.
I read that for a second in the subtitles. I convinced myself I was a useless bitch.
Oh.
But he said burden.
Sam and his hero shot.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
There you go, right?
Thank you, Jesus.
Literally. Dude, this shaky camera stuff is so intense. It's so funny.
He's going to his final form.
Even further beyond!
See?
Yes, maybe think about it for 3 seconds.
You
bearded weirdo.
Dumb piece of shit.
He is so fucking stupid.
You dumb, stupid, weak, pathetic, white, guilt.
Oh my god.
Ah, you fucking dummy.
You gotta put a button on the best goddamn speech of your life, buddy.
Run,
bitches.
No, he's good. He knows. He's like, you can do it.
Oh!
intense dude is intense.
Nice.
Yeah.
Cut off the hand.
This guy.
Cut off the fucking hand.
Oh, who did it?
Oh, it's that old guy. Guy with the crow's feet.
Yeah.
Ah, there he is.
Nice.
Thank God.
Get your extra bitch ass out of here, motherfucker. Like, damn it.
He's like, this is clearly all chill. Like, girl,
yeah.
Guys, fine. It's fine.
Stop freaking the fuck out.
Trespassing on my property. You didn't win shit in my yard.
Wait.
All of you.
Daddy, chill.
What the hell is even that?
This is like some like Resident Evil shit where like they break down the.
It looked like the Umbrella Corp thing from the top a little bit. Is there
fucking? No, smoking hot babe. Did he just?
Also known as an eccentric. Okay, I like this guy. He's a weird old wily fucker. I'm into it.
He's into Vore. He's fuck.
Right.
Oh, he's
Vore and a gigantic woman.
Soka.
その地下室に行けば全てわかる。
Oh, he told him about the basement. Okay.
I don't know. Maybe we're just in a situation that is absolutely extraordinary in every way, and we need to exhaust any possibility of anything that might help us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. That fucking bearded piece of shit stressed me out.
Yeah. That was over nothing. I don't know why he stressed us out so hard.
Talk about it for a second. Like, you know, Robert Kirkman came in and wrote one scene.
Exactly.
I dig this dude.
He's giving me kind of an Uncle T.
Yeah, yeah.
Vibes.
Yeah, I can see that.
Like, everyone's freaking out, and he's just like, whatever, chill, man.
It's very calm. It's like, listen, we could just maybe consider it, you know?
I do like these little crop top jackets, too.
He's like, I don't know, man. I don't fucking get it. We're worth a try, you know?
Nice.
Yeah.
They haven't destroyed everything yet.
Yeah.
That's a cool shot.
Salvageable. Yeah, the kind of the grandeur of it was like, it seems like we haven't seen...
It's a little bit of a change in animation too. They didn't do a lot of like shots like this before, where they like these like wider grand shots.
Well, we always seem to see it. They would do it from like a literal like a schematic or almost like a map type of a thing or whatever it was, and like whereas like that was literally just like a big wide
and also
helicopter shot like, and shit. You know,
the close up shots of like they're almost like westerns where it was like these close ups of his eyes and like mm-hmm. that stuff. They never really did that to it at the same extent before. So
to the extent that they did it here,
yeah, it's interesting.
Cool. Okay, pause.
Ooh, pause.
Boop.
Fucking episode 10, it was like Mr. like Armin goes to Washington. He was pleading his fucking case to fucking like Senator like Dickhead McBeardston over there or whatever it is.
So that guy annoying. Fucking that sucks. Guy he doesn't have the temperament to be in the army, man.
It's also anime, so like everybody's already kind of screaming at like a fucking 5 like anyway, but he was at like fucking 15 or whatever.
Yeah. He was ready to murder those kids.
Right. It was really kind of frustrating, and it was a little weird and sort of frustrating when, like, they're just kind of just like, we need to get out of here.
Yeah,
like,
we need to get out of here, but should we get out of here?
I need to vocalize literally every single thing that I'm saying. And I think that's just the form.
Like, to be fair, though, like, you guys were very frustrated. They weren't saying that stuff out loud. He was saying that stuff in his head.
I know 100%. That, but I don't need to hear him think that monologue, like, 5 times every season.
Yeah.
Because he's had that exact monologue in his head before.
Anime.
I know, right, but
that it's just I think it was coupled because they've done that before and I've enjoyed those things like, you know, where they have like a minute where he's kind of reflecting on like a battle or something like that.
Yeah.
And it's clearly the inner monologue and that kind of, I think it was just the baked in, you have 15 seconds.
And it was, you know, way like longer than 15 guns seconds. Trained on I'm you. Like,
there's a carcass. There's a smoldering fucking carcass of a fucking Titan or whatever the fuck it is. It's right here. And like, this is, I think it was just the immediacy of the scenario and like how we just kind of like wanted it to sort of alleviate itself. But I love Pixies. I love this the commander, like the old commander guy and stuff like that.
What's his name? Don Pixis? Dot Pixis, yeah.
Dot Pixis. Oh, his name's Dot. Oh, good old Dotty.
Good old Dotty over there. I like it. I mean, I'm calling him Captain Crow's Feet over there.
Captain Crow's Feet.
Like, he was exactly what you said, Morgan, where it's just like, this guy just is a little... just has the temperament to actually do this and shit. You know what I mean?
But did they say that he had never seen a Titan up front? Is that what they said? He'd never seen a female Titan. That's what he said.
Yeah, because he wanted to get...
He'd like to get eaten once. By a big old female Titan.
And he didn't say smoking hot babe, but he did say, like, burning hot.
A smoking hot Titan.
How did he say smoking hot? He said, like...
burning hot?
Burning lady Titan or something.
Right, but there was something where he just, maybe a buxom female Titan or something.
But I remember like it would translate, if I was doing the subtitles, I would have been like, smoking hot babe Titan.
It's exciting that we now have the prospect of like the Recon and a Titan like fighting together.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
What if he could fucking take like Aaron like picks up a couple of fucking commanders? Like, listen, we don't want to spend the fucking gas.
That is he just like rides on their shoulder. Yeah,
yeah, can man.
He
rides on their shoulder or just fucking toss me, bro.
Exactly. Like, just toss me.
My ass like all the because I know how to do this stuff. I can fly through the air and shit. You know what I mean? Like, and then like it, and you don't have to expend like the fuel or whatever.
Kind of like a Wolverine, like the Cannonball Special. Like,
yeah, just,
like,
you don't have to use all your Soda Streams up.
Fucking
yeah.
Angry, like our Angry Birds my ass over to the other side of the fucking thing or whatever.
Totally.
You know? That's very exciting. It's exciting because for a second I was like, is he going to be like on the run for a minute?
Mm. You know I thought I mean? Maybe, yeah.
We really thought we were going to get to that basement.
We're going to get the fuck out of Dodge. Maybe, right, maybe like the new big colossal Titan or the fucking wall breaker Titan or whatever are gonna show up and he was really going to have to prove himself then. But it's but it's nice that he doesn't have to do it. You just need a chill fucking guy who doesn't moisturize to come over and fucking and like and fucking hang out and kind of set everybody's fuck get everybody's mind right about like what you know what they can possibly do. So and so he's got a he says he they're basically what they want to secure the thing, so he's got to clog up that wall, right? And that's what's gonna happen.
Yeah, keep him from coming in, and then they have to go have a Recon team that goes and retakes some land.
Yeah, for sure. And then we got to get to the basement. So we didn't get to the basement, but we are keeping eyes on that shit. Like, that's in our minds, and like that's gonna happen pretty soon. Maybe it'll happen in like the midway point of the season or something.
How many are
like
in the season? Like 20?
25, I want to say. So we're coming up on the halfway point.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, we're almost at the halfway point. So maybe we'll get there and we'll have some revelation. I just want to know. Now we find out what the fuck's in there, but I just want to hear it from his dad's mouth. Like, what the fuck is going on?
Well, also, like, and he was saying, "Is like, where's my dad been for the past 5 years?"
Because he's been fucking MIA.
He's in the wind.
And is like one of the Colossal Titans his dad?
Whoa.
Is
it? Why is his dad trying to mess up humans? Why is he? What's his deal? Like,
that's
why?
What I'm saying. Like, no, we still don't know what the fuck is going on with these guys.
Yeah, yeah,
but it's potentially a human reason.
Yeah, because like that dad wanted to kill his mom.
Oh no.
Because that Titan let all the Titans in right to his like wife and children. Yeah, so yeah, I feel
yeah,
like
I mean he did do that, which that pokes a hole in it if he
that's
actually
some Omni Man shit right there.
Yeah.
The Viltrumites right. are coming.
Why did you make me do this? You know what I mean? Like that's what he's yeah, right? Like the Titan problem is now it's interesting because like we still don't know like their genesis or like where they came from, but the aims and the goals and the things, especially of like the big boys, like the big crazy ones, are like human problems now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? So that's interesting, I think. But I mean, yeah, I don't know. I don't know. Sasha was in it for like a hot second, but not nearly enough.
She was just hungry.
Yeah,
she was just hungry.
She had stomach pains.
She is such a weird kind of out there, like some guy is like literally like trying to kill himself, like or he's considering killing himself.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I don't know, it'd be cooler if we had some potatoes, man.
She's like, I'm upset too, because I'm hungry.
She was like, my stomach hurts. No, like maybe it's because she's so hungry.
No, they were like, look at Sasha's like cool as a cucumber, why can't you be like her? And all of a sudden she goes, ah, and you think it's because she's freaking out because the toll of war. No, it's because she's hungry. That was a joke.
I didn't think it was because she was hungry. I thought it was because her stomach hurt. Like not.
She said literally because she's hungry.
I think she has like stomach cramps from being hungry.
Yeah, that was the joke.
Oh, is that what it?
That was the joke of like she's freaking out.
I thought she was sick. I didn't think it was being hungry.
It could be that, but that was how I read it as a joke where she's got hunger pains because she's fucking.
It's the only time she's ever like super upset is she's hungry.
She's a country. Exactly. That's the only thing that really gets her goat. Like she's a country gal. She's just like you're out there. You're dispelling all this energy. You got to eat when you can. And so she fucking, that's kind of
Jesus,
like
she's as country
MO.
As a buttered biscuit.
Sure, buttered biscuit.
Yeah.
Okay. Totally. I mean, oh my god, I could go for some butter biscuits right now. Yeah, like that was like
biscuits gravy sounds good. Real good right now.
Sounds really good right really now. Hungry. Maybe we gotta go get some butter biscuits. Maybe that's what we're gonna do. I don't know. I do know that we want to keep going with this fucking show though.
Yeah.
I've been having a great time fucking covering it. We hope you guys have had a good time watching us and everything. And we are getting ready to gear up to do episode 11. But I'll tell you one thing, if you want to find out what we think about episode 11 right now, at this very moment,
you can do it.
You can do it right now. Like, you don't have to wait. You don't have to wait till next week to see our reactions to episode 11. You can just pony up $5 on our Patreon. The link is downstairs.
The link is in the basement.
The link is in the basement, and the basement is in the description and in the top pinned comment of this fucking video right now. But you head on over to our Patreon, you pony up $5, and you get to go ahead by one episode. You get to go ahead and get early access to episode 11, and you get it full and uncut.
Wait, what?
Oh, he's lying to him a little bit. He's making it more official.
Rebranding.
So any of the things that we may have cut for time, any jokes or stuff like that we may be cut for time, you get to see all of those, and you get to see them right now on our Patreon if you would be so kind to do so. And if you can't do that, but you had a good time watching this thing, just hit us with a like and a subscribe. It helps us out tremendously, and we appreciate y'all, and we'll see y'all later.